All right, no, 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 okay, I got one, okay? Is there anything in there?
Doesn't look like it.
Doesn't look like it? I don't think there's anything in there. There's nothing in there. We're really empty, totally empty. All right. Do you help your mommy with the wash?
Mm-hmm.
You do? Right. So then you must know that you're not supposed to put black clothes and white clothes in the same wash. You've done it. It's not very good, is it?
Not always.
Well, let's see what happens, because this is my clown washing machine, and this is the only washing machine I got, and I only have time to do one load. So I'm going to put it in there. You have to use the magic wand. What's the magic words today?
Never.
That works. Sounds like an adult, though. The kids will say I'll peanut butter sandwich or something, because they picked it up from Sesame Street and all that sort of stuff. So, or they have, you know, or I finally get in there because I want them to say something different, stupid. It's like pickle pop, or, you know, whatever comes out of my head at that moment becomes the magic word. And the magic word's a connection, because the magic word is something you get everybody to shut up and everybody pays attention. So, okay, abracadabra it is. You ready? Okay. Say abracadabra.
Abracadabra.
Well, that didn't convince me.
Abracadabra?
What about you guys? Well, we're washing the clothes. I'm really worried about this. I'm really worried about this.
Oh, dear.
Because that's what happens. Wow. I think you broke the washing machine. But you know what? If we have faith, maybe we can get these back. You think? There's nothing in there yet, right? Okay, I'm going to put them back in. Abracadabra.
Abracadabra.
Abracadabra. Well, that was pretty good. I think they said that pretty loud, so they fixed it.
Oh.
Parents get this one more than the kids. Okay. So you guys will all get this one. Believe it or not. This is a rope, right? I sometimes ask the kids and they'll say, everything's a rope. This is a rope, right? Is this rope tied?
No.
It's not tied. No. You sure?
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna have to do some magic on it. I'm gonna throw it in my magic box. What's the words? It came out tied. Sometimes, depending on how old the kids are, the kids get it.
Yeah.
But the parents always laugh about it. Okay, Becky. Here's one of the nice fun ones that you guys will all get as well. I think I need another helper. I grew up in Woodstock. This is like my favorite freaking magic wand, man. I found this one and I couldn't resist it. Is he cool?
He is very cool.
I think your name's Frank. I may own the four, but I can read. Actually, this clown is now 1 day old.
One day.
Today's my 1 day birthday, so I'm going to remember that. 1 day birthday. All right, I need you to help me. We're going to build a car. We're going to pretend to build a car. We're going to help everybody put all the ingredients in here to build a car.
Woo.
Everybody want to be a car?
Sure.
Yeah.
We can only get one, though, so I guess we'll have to have a raffle. All churches do raffles. Y'all ready? Okay, you come with me. What goes in the car? What goes in the car?
The chicken.
Yes, there's some gas in there. You say, put some gas in there.
Gas.
Yes. Oh, so is the car. Oh, come on now. Huh?
Steering wheel.
Steering wheel. Throw a steering wheel in there. There we go. What else goes in the car? The magic words.
Abracadabra.
Everybody's got it? Are you sure? Nice and loud?
Abracadabra.
Uh-oh. Oh, God, a car I could build is a toy Yoda. I had to go around to people, and I sent out the feeler, and I said, I don't know what to do. They said, you got a bird hand. I said, yeah, I got a bird hand. You can find a toy Yoda, right? Because it was a Star Wars movie opening. So, toy Yoda. Thank you, sir. What a match, by the way. Christian-oriented that you would use when you're out with the kids. This is really, really fun, kind of regular birthday party magic that a clown can extend from 3 to 5 minutes on each one of them just by playing with everybody. I have a lot of fun doing that. The age of the kids, I love 4 and 5 year olds. When you get 8, I don't want to be there. 8 year olds are one of the toughest audiences, aren't they? You like 8s? Yeah. They can be really, it depends on the group you run into. Some 8-year-olds can be like super into it, and others are like, yeah, I'm over here on the dance doing the TV thing, and I don't really want to see you. Which has happened at my last birthday party, actually. They were all like 8-year-olds, and they had this dance party program going on the TV. It took all I had to get the attention on me. And I was being paid to be there. It was like, okay. Alright, so, 2 things that happened. Well, that'll be that last. I said to Kevin, I had a hard time with this because, like I said, I'm kind of a layman in that I can't remember the numbers, I can't remember the, scripture passages. What I do is tell stories. This story is about my light. My light shines, and it glows, and it moves through life. God made me with a really great light. Okay, so my light is happy, and it's free. And it's good, as long as God is my best friend, and I do good things. My light is way up there. Sometimes, however, and if I sell this to little kids, sometimes, however, sin kind of tags along. And how would I sin? Ah, you know what? I might sin when I lie or fib. And that sin will grow and get bigger, and my balloon goes down. My light goes away. Because it likes to go as a balloon. And it's hanging on to me, and it's heavier than me, and it's taking me down. And at one point, I want God back as my best friend. I'm going to have to ask Jesus to forgive my sins, because Jesus came to earth so he could help us learn to love God more and learn about how we can be forgiven for our sins. He died for us to be that way. So Jesus will take his hand and wrap his hand around us. And he will be just wonderful. And we're going to use this at the end of the program too. I'm going to show you where this goes. And he brings back my life. And he brings back my life as a light bulb. Because I now have all kinds of wonderful thoughts and things in my head. And the sin is forgiven. And I can move on and bring joy and happiness to others. So this little light's become. There are other ones that very effectively a child could watch and understand that if I don't tell lies, and the little things I say, I mean, when I read the script originally for that one in the book, it's, they use big words, some of these guys, self-righteous and righteousness, and the kid's going to sit there and go, what the heck are you talking about? Right? You got to be down on their level to say, you lied. You hurt somebody. You pushed your friend down. What did you do to sin? Now how can you be forgiven? So that's where we go with that. This is why I'm asking volunteers to help me with this one. I have distributed three things over there. One is yellow. Can Mr. Yellow come up? Or Mrs. Yellow? That's right, I gave it to Mrs. Yellow.